Hi and welcome to this demo of Soliton's USB Power Delivery Test Suite and LabVIEW API. I'm Anand Krishnan. I'm Business Unit Manager Semiconductor for Soliton Technologies. Customers around the world are moving from USB Type A and Type B based devices, which offer fixed power capabilities, to the USB Type C connector based devices, which allow for negotiated power up to 100 watts at upwards of 20 volts. The way these devices achieve this is using a power negotiation protocol called the USB Power Delivery Standard. Soliton's test suite offers a compliance test for this standard, while also giving you the modularity and the granularity in your test APIs to fashion your own test cases, to test the corner cases of your product, and also understand the failure modes better. A quick note about the hardware setup. The solution is based on NI's PXI chassis. It could be one driven by a PXI embedded controller or by a PXI MXIE controller with a connection to the PC. The key component in the system is NI's FlexRio module. It could be either the 7965R or the 7966R or similar FPGA-based module. You don't see that module here because there's a NI5781 front end before it. Also needed is a PXI SMU that can manage the voltage and current ranges that your product requires. I happen to have a PXI 4130 here. A good baseline would be the PXI 4139. This SMU is going to be connected to your VBUS line, whereas the FlexRio and the transceiver are going to be interfaced to the CC lines of your product. Also included is a Soliton interface board that goes from the PXI FlexRio front end and the PXI SMU over to your device. The Soliton interface board can be powered by a plus and minus 5 volt bipolar supply. The USB PD test suite and API is today ready for downward facing ports or devices that can source power. In coming months, Soliton will add capability for devices that can sync power. The solution can handle USB PD spec Rev3 and Rev2. Included are the physical layer specification tests for Chapter 5, and there are 200 MHz digitizers that let you do sufficient timing and voltage resolution to do a full-fledged TX and RX eye diagram. Also included is the protocol layer Chapter 6, power supply layer Chapter 7, vendor-defined messaging. A quick note on the software components. On the one hand, customers get an integrated, intuitive GUI that allows you to both configure and select tests that you want to run. These tests are modeled around the different chapters described in the previous section. Also included is a modular and sequence-ready set of APIs, which is available as a LabVIEW palette. These APIs are organized by different levels of abstraction, such as the test layer, the instrument driver layer, the messaging layer, the packet formation layer, and down to the bit layer. This picture gives you a brief overview of how the different pieces come together. At the lower end is a highly flexible and hardware-timed FPGA-based PD protocol engine. Most customers never need to touch this layer. Also included is an abstraction around the NI DC power driver, which operates and configures the NI SMUs in the system, usually for VBUS loading and monitoring. Above this is the scriptable API that we talked about. It is sequence ready and modular and organized with different layers of abstraction. And on top of these, Soliton already provides a set of tests, which you already saw in the integrated test GUI. But we also allow you the capability, which is rather differentiated in the market, to define your own tests using the modular APIs that are USB PD friendly. So a quick note on the differentiators. If you're doing R&D validation, you have both the protocol compliance capability and the ability to gauge fault behavior using the LabVIEW API. You also have the capability to integrate USB PD tests with non-PD tests, let's say protocol validation or startup validation or power supply advanced dynamic behavior and any such things. That capability is useful both for R&D validation and production test, where PD might not be the only feature in your device. And for production test, you get the compactness and ruggedness of the NI-PXI platform. All right, now we're going to show you what the solution looks like under the hood at the software end. What I have open is my LabVIEW block diagram and the function palette within the block diagram. And if you navigate to user libraries, you'll see the USB PD validation folder or palette. You have the most highest level VIs, which are the initialize PD session, configure PD session, and close session. But within that, you have the test organization. And the tests typically reflect the different chapters of the specification and the subchapters within. So as you see here, you have the physical layer and where you have the receiver test, RX validation, TX validation, and such. And you have a few lower level organizations within the tests, like, for example, connecting your RD. Well, you also have the source tests, which are the power supply tests. You have the protocol or link layer tests. You have the vendor-defined messages, and two recent entrants are the PPS and the quick charge tests. Another level of organization is the instrument drivers. These are just abstractions around the PXI equipment that the solution uses. The transceiver on the one hand, the power source on the other hand, they're abstracted for USB PD specifically. You also have the message layer, where you're framing the messages at a higher level. And if you want to get down to the lower level, you have the packet framing, the packet payload framing layer. And as you can see here from the frame packet payload VI, all typical PD messages are represented. You have both the control messages and the data messages and the BIST messages inside. If you want to open one of these VIs, there's enough documentation for you to know what's going on. And you're allowed to go pretty deep in the VI hierarchy. So if you want to move, mix, or match things around, there's plenty of capability to do that. Now, the highest level available is what we call the wrapper GUI. The wrapper GUI is essentially a test selection, test configuration, and test run GUI. So as you see here, you have configurability for each of a variety of tests. I think there must be around 30 tests over here relating to different chapters of the specification. And you have a good number of parameters available for each of your tests. You have the plots for the eye diagram. And you have the run screen. For every run, you get pretty detailed plots of the PD protocol. There it is. And additionally, you get pretty detailed CSV reports of not only the protocol waveforms, but also the detailed results. Okay, let's take a look at what the report formats generated by the tool look like. On the one hand, for your run, you will have overall status report, which is a CSV file, and this is what it looks like. There is, as you see, a row for each test and subtest, where the test result is documented, but also within each test you have different measurements, and the list of measurements is different for each test. If you see the bitrate and bitrate drift test, you get a bunch of parameters like the, you know, your P bitrate, F bitrate, and other kinds of scalar results. And that list changes for each test. And as you scroll down, you see all the tests that you've run are represented over here. On the other hand, you have some more detail within the folder. There is a subfolder for each test that you ran. And within that subfolder, every transaction of the PD protocol that was executed is represented. So you have PNGs for what the transaction scope shot looked like. And you also have the raw data in a CSV file if you want to process it for something. And for specific tests, you also have some additional information. If you take the eye diagram as an example, you'll have a plot of the 0 and 1 eye, what it looked like and how it looked compared to the limits. In this case, the red lines are the limit and the colored lines are the actual eye. You have one for the 0 and another for the 1. So if you want to customize this report for any reason, feel free to reach out to us. But all the information from your test is available at a pretty granular level. Whether your interest is in production test or R&D validation of your USB power delivery product, the Soliton solution has you covered. On the hardware end, you get the compactness of the PXI without losing out on the modularity, because if you wanted to add another element like the protocol validation or power supply advanced testing or dynamic testing to your setup, the Pixie solution allows you to stack more cards to do that. On the software end, you get both the integration of the high-level tests for each of the chapters of the specification, but you still get the modularity of the low-level APIs and the framing APIs. We hope you enjoyed this preview of the Soliton Test Suite and API. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to sales@solitontech.com. We'll be happy to help you.